Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can find out minimum and second minimum from an array by passing array into function. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the link youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechMS, which is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement a program in C which will find out minimum and second minimum from an array, and I have to pass array into function. So first I am including a header file, then I am declaring a function min smin. So its return type is void, and it will receive an argument of integer type it will receive an argument of integer type array. So this is function declaration. Then I am implementing main function. Then printf statement, which will display the message enter 10 numbers on console. To receive those 10 numbers, I am implementing for loop, which will repeat 10 times. And it will repeat scanf statement. So all the elements will be stored inside A array using this for and scanf. Now I am calling min smin function, and I am passing array inside it. So this statement is function calling, and then I am using return 0. Here return type of min smin function is void, so no values will be received here. So output will be displayed inside the definition of min smin function. So min smin function will be calculating two values, minimum and second minimum. That's why return type of function is void, because a function cannot return more than two values. So void min smin int a. So this is the block which will be known as function definition. Inside this block, I am declaring a variable I min, which will be initialized by 32766 and smin 32767. These are the largest elements of integer range. Then for loop, which will repeat 10 times. Inside this loop, I am going to implement first if condition, which will check whether a of I is less than min. So if this condition is true, then I have to assign the current minimum into smin, because the current minimum is lesser than a of I. So a of I will become new minimum. So the current minimum will be second minimum now. So smin equals to min, and min equals to a of I. So I have assigned the current minimum into second minimum, and a of I, which is the new minimum, is assigned into min variable. If this condition is true, it means a of I is not less than min, it is greater than min. But now I can check whether a of I is less than smin or not. So if a of I is greater than min, but it is less than second minimum, then I have to check one more condition, that a of I should not be equals to minimum. So now see this condition. If first if condition is false, it means a of I is greater than minimum. Then else part will be evaluated. It is checking a of I is less than second minimum, but it should not be equals to minimum. So it means number is between min and second minimum. So it can be assigned into second min. So this way I have calculated both the values, minimum and second minimum. After completion of loop, I can print the result on console using this printf. So minimum equals to %d, then slash n, second minimum equals to %d, comma min, comma smin. So this will print the result on console. So now the complete code is implemented. Here I have passed array into function, and function is calculating minimum and second minimum value, which is available inside array. Now I am executing this code. You can see it is asking for 10 numbers. I am going to enter 10 values from 1 to n, and it is printing the result minimum equals to 1 and second minimum equals to 2. So the output is correct. The code is working properly. I hope you have understood the code well. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the link youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechImage, which is available on Google Play. Thank you for watching this video.